Good morning, students. Again, we are coming with the next series of the lecture, Robotic Process Automation. In this particular lecture, we will discuss recording. In previous lecture, we have already started the unit 4, that is data manipulation and recording. In previous lecture, we have already discussed what is data manipulation, how data can be manipulated by using robotic process automation. In this particular unit, we will study the recording. Okay, recording, basically you can say that the recording is a collection of execution steps that has to be taken on the application in the scope in order to accomplish a task. Okay, I am telling you, collection of execution steps that has to be taken on application in the scope in order to accomplish a task. That is what the recording is. Okay, in this particular lecture we will discuss what is recording. I have already told you the definition of recording is okay, and then we'll discuss the basic types of recording or the category types of recording. Okay, the outline of this particular lecture is, we will discuss what the recording is in RPA, robotic process automation. Basically, these are the three types of recording: basic recording, desktop recording, web recording, and one more kind of recording is also introduced over here, that is Citrix recording. Okay, CITRIX, Citrix recording. These are the basic types of recording that we will discuss in this particular lecture and perform how the recording will take place will in lab. Okay, next. So you can say that there are four types of recording in UiPath Studio. We have already discussed the types of recording. Recording, an important functionality of UiPath Studio, as I am telling you, enables us to capture users' action on the screen and translate them into sequence. Okay, it saves a lot of time when you want to automate business process. Whenever you want to automate any kind of process or business process, it takes a less time, or you can say that the time you can save at that particular scenario. You can find recording option under design tab. While we will be in lab, then I will tell you where is the design tab. Okay, while you will open the UiPath Studio, at the top ribbon, or you can say that the top toolbar, there will be a ribbon where a design tab is to be placed. Okay, where the recording option is also placed. I'm telling you, and I will see the image of that particular platform. Okay, you can find recording option under design tab in UiPath Studio. An important point about recording is that some of the actions are not recordable. Okay, this you keep in mind. We are saying that recording is when you record the execution steps or any kind of business activity you are going to process. That particular step of instructions, or you can say that the execution steps for a particular task, that is what the recording is. But there are some tasks that are non-recordable. We will discuss those in detail in next lecture. Okay, types of recording. First of all, we have already discussed the types: basic recording, desktop recording, web recording, and Citrix recording. Okay, these are the four kinds of recording in robotic process automation or in UiPath. With the help of UiPath Studio, you can implement four kinds of recording. Okay, next, this is the screenshot that I was told you. Okay, I told you that I will show you the screenshot. This is the student screenshot of your UiPath Studio. In UiPath Studio, you can see over there will be an option of recording. While you press or while you click the mouse on this particular button, there it shows four kinds of recording that we have already discussed. Name are basic recording, desktop recording, web recording, and Citrix recording. Okay, now it depends upon us with what kind of recording we are going to perform. Okay, basically I just want to tell you these are the four types of recording and such types of screenshots you will see while you use recording feature of UiPath Studio. Okay. One more thing, the user can modify the recorded sequence even after the recording is over. While you are going to implement a particular task or a business process, you use the recording, okay, so that you can in future you can say you can see how the process is to be executed. Now I am telling you, user can modify the recorded sequence even after the recording is over. Okay, this is especially helpful in case where small changes has to be made in the recording sequence. If you want a lot of changes in that particular recording or in that particular activity, I think there is no need for changing or modifying that particular options. Okay, that's why I am telling you, especially this feature is helpful when small changes have to be made into the recording sequence. Okay, the option to modify an existing recording sequence thus ensure that there is no need to record the entire process again. Okay, basically there are four types of recording. First of all, we will discuss the basic recording. Okay, this is the basic recording. Basic recording is suitable for single activity. First of all, you all should keep in mind what kind of activity is suitable for which process, or you can say that at which scenario particular process or particular recording will be helpful. But we are talking about here basic recording. That is, you can say that it is suitable for single activity. It basically generates a full selector for each activity. It does not generate containers. Hence, the automation is slower in comparison to the other types that generates the container. Okay. Again, I am telling you, basic recording is what you used to record the activity on the desktop. Okay. While you use to record the activity on the desktop, this type of recording is used for single activities and you can say that simple workflows. We have already discussed that basic recording is helpful for single activity, but you can say that for a single workflows, you can use the basic recording. Okay, the action here are self-contained and not contained in separate window. While you work on the UiPath Studio, recording option was there. You simply click on the recording option. While you will click the recording option on the same window, you will perform the whole task. Okay, as shown in the screenshot that I have already seen you in the previous slides. Okay. Next we will discuss this is basic recording na? Then we will discuss the desktop recording. In desktop recording, as the name itself suggests, it is suitable for all types of desktop applications and multiple actions. It generates container and hence it is faster than basic recording. Now here you can understand the difference, you can tell the difference between the basic and the desktop recording is that basic recording is slower as comparison to the desktop recording, or vice versa, you can say that. Okay, all kinds of desktop applications, okay, for all kinds of desktop applications recording, this desktop recording is useful. Okay, in desktop recording, like basic recording, is used to record activities on the desktop. Okay, however, it is used to record and automate multiple actions and complex workflows. Again, I am telling you, in basic recording, I told you that particular recording is helpful for simple applications, but now I am telling you that is helpful for the complex applications. This you can say that it is the difference between the basic recording as well as the desktop recording. In this particular slides, you came to know that desktop recording is useful for complex application and it is faster than the basic recording. And as comparison to the basic recording, you can say that is used for simple applications and that is slower as comparison to the desktop recording, right? Okay, Next is web recording. Web recording means you can say that the web recorder, as the name suggests, is used to record actions on the web applications and the browser. This is the very short lecture. This is the very small lecture, but while you will going to implement the concepts on the lab or in your laptop or desktop, then you can clearly understand that what we have studied in this particular lecture. In web recording, this kind of recording is used to record visualized environment like VNC, virtual machines, etc. I have already told you that, as the name suggests, it is used to record actions on web applications and the browsers. Okay, it basically requires explicit positioning and allows only images, text, and keyboard automation. Okay, this is what the web recording is. And finally, is the Citrix recording. Citrix recording is used to record virtual machines. I have already told you, in web recording, you can use the VNCs and Citrix environment also. This recording allows only keyboards, text, images, and automations. We have already discussed the same thing in the web recording also. Okay, so almost you can say that your web recording and the Citrix recording is same up to some extent. Okay, as the name suggests, it is suitable for all types of desktop app and multiple actions. It generates container and send. It is faster than the basic recording. Again, the comparison for this particular recording is again with the basic recording. It is again faster. It is used for again complex processes, whatsoever the applications, whatsoever the desktop applications we are going to record in either web recorder, basic your desktop application, desktop recorder, Citrix recording is also do the same thing. Okay. Next is your textbook, but before proceeding the sections, I am telling you about some actions are recordable while others are not. We have already discussed the thing that each and every action within the process is not to be recorded. Those actions that are not to be recorded are those I am telling that particular point. For example, we are talking about the recordable actions. Recordable actions means you can say that left click on button. You can record the left click button, check boxes, drop down list, and other GUI element. Okay, text typing is also recordable. All such things that I am telling you is the recordable actions. But we have discussed many of the actions are those that are not recordable. Then actions that cannot be recordable are, you can say that keyboard shortcuts. You cannot record the keyboard shortcuts. Mouse hover. When you are doing mouse hover, that particular action cannot be recorded. You can simply right click, modifier keys such as Control and Alt cannot be recorded. Such types of keys cannot be recorded. Okay, so this is what the things that can be recorded. Basically, there are two types of recording. If we are not talking about desktop recording, basic recording, desktop recording, web recording, and Citrix recording, in layman language or in simple terms, you can say that basically there are two types of recording. First one is, you can say that automatic recording, and second one is manual recording. Automatic recording is what? The recording multiple actions in one go. Okay, in manual recording, the recording is used to record each step onto a time at a one time, and hence offer more control over the recording. So this is all about the desk recording. Okay, while the desktop, basic, and web recorders can automatically record multiple actions and manually records single actions on the screen, the Citrix recorder can only record a single action manual recording. According to me, now it is to be more clear to all of you that we have discussed desktop, basic, and web recording. And at fourth point, we have discussed the Citrix recording. Now I am telling you, if you records automatically, I have already told you the two types of recording. One is automatic and second one is manual. If you are talking about the automatic recording, that means we are talking about the desktop, basic, and web recorders. They can automatically record multiple actions. Okay, and manual recording, single actions on the screen. Okay, the Citrix recorder can only record a single action. So you can say that out of the four, the Citrix recording is the option that can be used for manually. Okay, and others you can use it for automatic recording. Okay, I think that is more than enough about the recording. We will discuss, we will implement how the recording is takes place while we perform a particular task in the lab. Okay, these are the references. We have already mentioned the same references that we have already provided to you in the previous lectures. Okay, thank you so much.